Take a trip with me to 1913, to Calumet, Michigan, in the copper country. I'll take you to a place called Italian Hall, where the miners are having their big Christmas ball. And I'll take you to a door and up a high stairs, singing and dancing is heard everywhere. Let you shake hands with the people you see, and watch the kids dance around the big Christmas tree. There's talking and laughing and songs in the air. The spirit of Christmas is there everywhere. Before you know it, you're friends with us all, and you're dancing around and around in the hall. You ask about work and you ask about pay. They tell you they make less than a dollar a day, working their copper claims, risking their lives. So it's fun to spend Christmas with children and wives. A little girl sitting down by the Christmas tree lights. Play the piano, so you gotta keep quiet. To hear all this fun, you would not realize that the copper boss thug men are milling outside. Copper boss thug stuck their heads in the door. One of them yelled and he screamed, there's a fire. A lady, she hollered, there's no such a thing. Keep on with your party, there's no such a thing. A few people rushed, but there's only a few. It's just the thugs and the scabs fooling you. A man grabbed his daughter and he carried her down, but the thugs held the door and he could not get out. And then others followed, 800 or more. Most everybody remained on the floor. The gun thugs laughed at their murderous joke, and the children were smothered on the stairs by the door. Such a terrible sight I never did see. We carried our children back up to their tree, and the scabs outside laughed at their spree. And the children that died, there were 73. Piano played a slow funeral tune. And the town was lit up by a cold Christmas moon. The parents, they cried, the miners, they mourned.